Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We take up another verse from the Bhramar Gita written by Surdas, who was a 16th century Hindu devotional poet and singer, known for his lyrics written in praise of Lord Krishna. Surdas wrote in Braj Bhasha, one of the two literary dialects of his time. He was a part of the Bhakti movement spreading across the Indian subcontinent. This movement represented spiritual empowerment of the masses. Mirabai, Kabir, Tulsidas were also a part of this movement. The genesis of Bhramar Gita poems can be traced to Srimad Bhagavat Puran. According to the narration in the Puran, the inhabitants of Braj could not reconcile with the loss of Krishna to Mathura. It may be recalled that Krishna moved to Mathura from Braj in order to meet and destroy Kansa, the king of Mathura, who was evil incarnate. In Braj, the depth of the sorrow of the gopis, the milkmaids, knew no bounds. Krishna sent Uddhav to Braj to pacify them. Uddhav went to Yashoda and Nand and explained to them the divinity of Krishna. He told them that Krishna was formless, unborn, without a beginning and an end, and omnipresent. He advised them to look for this Krishna rather than the child they had brought up. At this stage, the gopis, the milkmaids who used to play with Krishna, flirt with him, dance with him, sing with him, love him, touch him, caress him, took Uddhav aside and probed him to learn as much as they could about their beloved. They repeatedly chanted Krishna's name. Meanwhile, a black bee droned into this assembly. The gopis taunted Uddhav through the medium of this bee, Bhramara. That is why the verses are named Bhramara Gita. The song of the bee. Actually, all these songs are written as a repartee between the gopis and Uddhav. In the verse we are discussing today, Surdas writes, gopis say, how can they forget Krishna, who was their childhood friend? Larikai ko prem, kaho ali kaise karike chhutat. We started loving him right from his childhood. He grew up here. How can that be given up? How can we get rid of that love? Kaha kaho brajnath charit ab antar gati yu lutat. Brajanath, that is Krishna. How can we describe his character, his activities? He has looted our love. He resides in our heart. Chanchal chal manohar chitvan ve muskan mand dhuni gavat. Natvar bhesh nandan nand nandan ko vah vinod grihe van mein avat. उनकी चंचल गति, सुंदर चितवन और वे मुस्कुराहट तथा मंद मंद स्वरों में जब वे गाते थे, वे गाने का ढंग यही नहीं, जब वे नटवर वेश में नाना प्रकार के विनोद करते हुए वन से घर लौटते थे तो हमारा मन श्री कृष्ण की उस मुद्रा पर मोहित हो जाता था। The gopis emphasize again and again the various facets of the child who was growing up there. He was also a cowboy. When he returned in the evening with the cows, his gait, his looks, his smile, his flute, everything charmed them. They say, Charan Kamal ki shapath karit hain, ye sandesh mohi vish sam lagat. We swear by the lotus feet of Krishna, your message Uddhav, asking us to take to Gyan Yoga, Brahma Yoga, is like a poison to our ears. Suradas mohi nimishna visrat, mohan murati sovat jagat. Day and night, we cannot forget the image of Krishna that resides in our heart. Hey Uddhav, हमें सोते जागते किसी भी अवस्था में श्री कृष्ण की वह माधुर्यपूर्ण मूर्ति एक क्षण के लिए नहीं भूलती. हमारा प्रेम आकस्मिक नहीं, उसका उदय सो बचपन से हुआ था. ये बचपन का प्रेम कैसे छूट सकता है? दिस इज द एसेंस ऑफ दिस वर्स. वी जस्ट कांट फॉरगेट कृष्ण. Going back to Bhramar Geet and looking at its qualities as a literature and of its contents, I would say that Bhramar Geet is a fabulous combination of virha, grief of separation, gyan and bhakti. It is a composition in the face of which gyan takes a back seat. Here the entire logic of yoga accepts defeat. All that remains is absolute devotion, bhakti and bhakti alone. Bhakti is superior to gyan. Yoga, karma bhed and jati bhed. As a literature, Surdas primarily dwells in the rasas of Vatsalya, childhood, Shingar, Amor, and Shant, peace. With his burning intelligence and imagination, the poet has painted the childhood of Krishna in luminous colors. His descriptions are beautiful, alive, psychologically enriching. His Krishna is an embodiment of love and sweetness. Surdas combined bhakti and shringar to describe union and separation with an intensity seldom achieved elsewhere. Bhramar Geet is not only one of the most sublime writings on virha and shringar, but is also a unique discussion on sagun and nirgun. In the conversation between the gopis and Uddhav, we find a witty repartee and a penetrating satire. Surdas's verses not only reach a pinnacle of emotional content, but are also rated high for a poet's craft. His language is simple, expression spontaneous, and words full of learning. He is rich in imaginative similes and metaphors. Hazari Prasad Dwivedi, an eminent Hindi critic, writes, सूरदास जब अपने प्रिय विषय का वर्णन शुरू करते हैं, तो मानो अलंकार शास्त्र हाथ जोड़कर उनके पीछे दौड़ता है। उपमाओं की बाढ़ आ जाती है, रूपकों की वर्षा होने लगती है। एवरी वर्स इज फुल ऑफ यूनिक सिमिलीज एंड मेटाफर्स। सूरदास इज वन ऑफ द ग्रेट्स ऑफ हिंदी पोएट्री। ही नॉट ओनली एनरिच्ड लिटरेचर एंड इमोशन विद इमोशन एंड लिंग्विस्टिक एक्सलेंस बट ऑल्सो पायनियर्ड ए यूनिक ट्रेडिशन इन कृष्ण काव्य। I thank you for visiting this site and listening to me. We meet again soon. Have a nice day.